Now, as our custom on Sunday mornings, we'd like to take a little bit of time to work upon the health of our bodies, our own mental, spiritual, emotional well-being. So I'm going to ask if you would you sit back in your chairs, either put both feet flat on the floor or your ankles crossed, whichever is most comfortable for you. And let's take a few moments, let our eyes close, and focus in upon the reality that is within us that has been the source of all health and healing throughout our life. I turn away for a few moments and focus in on the innermost part of my own beingness, that beautiful presence within myself that has created me, that spirit, that mind, unending, that has given me and my soul birth and clothed my soul in a physical body. To that inner presence, to that light I turn now, that in quiet moments I may open up the entirety of my body, its creation, to the innermost reality of that light which is within me, that light which is the intelligence that runs the entirety of my body, that which goes far beyond my intellectual capacity, and yet is active right now, and every moment of every day in my life. I open myself to this innermost consciousness of light, of intelligence, and of beauty. That is the presence of the infinite and the eternal within myself. And as I do, let me feel that that light is entering into the very center of every cell of my body. They're adjusting the rhythms, motions, and energies of each and every cell, bringing the entirety of my body into a state of divine order and equilibrium. A state of balance, a state of polarity, where my body, mind, and soul are in a divine synthesis with the universal mind and spirit of God. For my body is as a temple clothing the presence of God, and God's innermost light radiation is given into all parts of that temple, right here and right now, that spirit may live in a healthy body, that the mind of God may function through healthy consciousness, and so the entirety of all levels of my mind are open to light, to be cleansed, to be purified, and in that cleansing and in that purification, my mind and my emotions are at peace. For I feel and open myself to the ultimate unity, which is the ultimate love, which is the divine within myself. Here within, I am that which I am. At peace, and my body functioning and working harmoniously throughout my beingness. I relax in the divine serenity that lives within me, bringing peace to my body, my mind, and my soul. I allow this, I invite it, I accept it, God's gift to me, in health, in the radiance of spirit living in and through me. For this realization, of health and healing. This day and every day of my life, I give thanks. I let it be so. And so it is. Last Sunday, I spoke upon the idea of clearing your mind of negatives, and I felt I hadn't said enough about this subject, so we're going to go into part two. Why is it so important? Let me remind you of clearing the mind of negativity. Because until we clear the mind of negativity, it would always come back to haunt our positiveness. The mind becomes the house divided against itself, and so whatever you try to do on a conscious level to fill yourself with all types of conscious positiveness, to allow even in a mystical sense the God self to come through you, it has to then be filtered through all of this negativity and doesn't come forth in full force and full blossom and power. Therefore, as long as we keep this negativity inside of us, no matter what system of religion, no matter what technique we use in order to be able to thrust our life forward, it isn't going to go that far. And the reason for it is because we are in a house in conflict with itself. One part of us is saying, I'm one with God, I'm one with the universe, I'm one with Christ, I'm one with Buddha, choose your semantics, however they might be. But the other part is at war and say, no, you're a slob, you're mediocre, you failed at this and that. Why do you think you're godly? Don't kid yourself. And that would be, in the traditional Christian sense, the devil speaking to us. The devil is no more than a composite of all of the negative energies that we have experienced and festers in our personal subconscious. And therefore, the idea of clearing this out is all important. And to do this, I offered some methods last week, and let's go into it now, starting with, if you'll pull out your affirmation sheet with the first one, where it says auric protection. In the Bible it says, you shall put on your armor of light. Now the armor of light is understood to be an auric field and an auric shield that exists around us. All of us are a primary energy field as far as our body is concerned, and then that radiates out and forms an auric field or auric energy all around the physical body, wherever we are, whatever we're doing. At the same time, everybody else that we're coming into contact with, whether it's in traffic, whether it's in the supermarket, wherever it might be, they are giving off their particular auras and their particular energies. At the same time, the human mind is part of the universal mind. The universal mind acts as a medium for the transference of thought telepathically. And therefore, whatever everybody is thinking in this universe right now, you can be sponge-like and taking into your system if you are not cautious about it. In other words, sometimes, let's suppose you wake up early one morning and you're really in a good mood and you go into the office where you work, as an example. And all of a sudden you start to feel, the moment you walk through the door, nobody has to say anything to you. But the moment you walk through the door, all of a sudden, it's as if something begins to flatten inside of you. You don't know exactly what it is, but it may be that the very general energy that people are giving off, and it might not be more than even one person if it's a small office, that energy is impregnating your energy field, and in so doing, it's creating more negative energy in your personal subconscious, which depresses your nervous system, depresses your outlook, etc., etc. So what do? Or you go into a doctor's office, you're not feeling well. God, I can't stand going into a doctor's office. The waiting room, that is, oh boy, it's like a minefield in there. There are all these people sitting there. I mean, if you only felt half bad when you went in, you know, 10 minutes in the waiting room, and now you're really, you know, it's ready for 911. I mean, it's bad. Forget the doctor. Call the ambulance. Because you're taking it in. And everything, including sound, has a particular energy to it. So when you hear somebody coughing, it's like a bad melody. You know, who would want to hear a beautiful song with that kind of background? You know, you can't put great words of joy and happiness to that kind of thing. Same situation implies that when we are near anything where we feel this type of situation, and we should do this just automatically as we start every day. When we are getting up in the morning, maybe as we're showering and we're bathing ourselves and so forth, we can sort of even give ourselves a little bit of an auric cleansing. We can just simply go like this. If there's been anything, if I've had any bad dreams, out. Bad dreams, out. Nightmares, out. Energy. Energy of the hand, the arm, working on the energy of the body, out, out, out. So not only are you using the soap, the lather, and so forth, but as you're doing the body motion, get into the idea. You're eliminating negative energy. Now, at the same time, we don't want somebody else's junk entering us, because that's what it is. It's junk. This whole society is part of a neurotic planet. I mentioned it a couple of weeks ago. This is not the planet Earth. It's the planet neurosis. And for that reason, we're born here. We're born here with this particular mission of raising above the neurosis, awakening to that which is above the neurosis, as it were. So when we go to auric protection, the affirmation says, every day I take a few moments to visualize or imagine an aura of white protective God light surrounding my body and shielding it from outside negative energy influences. That can be anywhere, anything, or anyone or group of people. Because that energy is all around you. Now, I don't want you to become spiritually paranoid here and feel that wherever you go, there is negative energy. But the truth of the matter is, there is. Because people are unaware. They're unawakened. And so we have to be very, very cautious with this. So just imagine every day, when you start off your day, that all around you is this beautiful white auric emanation of light that's emanating forth from the upper torso of your body, the heart center. The body is like a miniature universe. It's the infinite, has taken finite form, and the center of the universe, as far as we're concerned, is in the upper torso of our body, and that this light is radiating out around you, giving you this protective aura of light. The next says music. It says, whenever possible during my daily activities, I play beautiful music whose energy I feel myself absorbing into my body-mind energy field, transforming negative energies into positive energies. In other words, just don't listen to it. But imagine you're just like a sponge. And as you hear this music, feel that you're just taking it into your system, that your body is very, very porous, which it really is. It's an energy field, and you're taking the energy of this beautiful music, and it's as if your body has become part of the composition and the score of this music, so that you feel the beauty of this. And it doesn't have to be the music as we ordinarily think of music. It can be chanting, it can be things that deal with something spiritual of a higher order. Whatever it is that gives you this feeling, could be drumming, could be anything that gives you this feeling of a higher frequency of energy and beingness. Then it says humming. It says, when playing beautiful music, I hum to the music and feel that the humming energy vibrations are vibrating through my body, mind, energy field, transforming negative energies into positive energies. Now, all of you may have at home some beautiful piece of music that you could quietly hum to, and it wouldn't put any type of great emphasis strain on your nervous system to hum along. I've used Ave Maria for a number of years, and I just hum, and as I hum to that or something similar, I feel Now, as I'm humming, I feel that hum. I feel. And if you start to hum in this way, that humming sound goes through you. Now, it's for those of you that are a little astute here spiritually. Hum, hum. Can do this in many, many different ways, but if you do it, it is just like removing the spiritual essence of anything that is negative from you and leaving you in the spiritual purity. And so I really suggest that even at the first signs, perhaps, of where you don't feel well, for health, you start not to feel well, you put on a beautiful piece of music, and you give yourself a humming treatment. You're becoming like a humming songbird. Okay? Next says fragrance. Now, all of you know what a bad scent is. You know, a skunk can represent a bad scent. And it's no reason that some people are called skunks, is it? Because they don't have to have any kind of bad cologne on or bad perfume. They just emanate this. Fragrance is an energy. One fragrance is distinguished from another fragrance, is that one energy is one fragrance, another energy is a different fragrance. Now, I really believe that fragrance can cause a great change in recent times here with aromatherapy and so forth, which is now becoming mainstream. That sort of amuses me. When it first started out more in metaphysical and New Age circles and so forth, and a lot of people thought, oh, this is just plain hooey, who cares about it, this is just another whatever. But now I notice on television I see commercials for different air fresheners and so forth that deal with aromatherapy. And it is interesting how, again, these things have gone mainstream. Mainstream in the sense of we begin to accept things that we thought perhaps years ago were not so good. So therefore, let's look at the affirmation. It says, I recognize that fragrance is an energy. And so at least once daily, I expose my senses to a beautiful fragrance, whose energies transform negative energies into positive energy in my body, mind, and spiritual field. Whatever fragrance appeals to you. Now, for many, many years, I'm actually going into decades, before I ever step out to give a lecture or a sermon or a seminar or whatever, I carry my own particular cologne with me, and I give myself a couple of spritzes before I start to lecture. Why? Because a particular type of cologne that I use has almost an aromatherapy type of an effect on me. It makes me feel my senses and so forth. It makes me feel good and feeling at a very even keel. So use this. Incense is a marvelous, marvelous thing. It's been used in religion down through the ages because a good type of incense tends to tranquilize the mind. You're burning incense, and if it is not tutti frutti or orange sherbet or something else, if it's something that's from the old school sandalwood, I know sandalwood doesn't sound very exciting, does it? But sandalwood will do, or just rose, or even musk, yes, even musk. Choose your fragrance, and then take a little bit of time, at least once a day, burn a cube, a stick, however you care to ignite the fragrance. At least once a day, do something in your home, your residence, where you live. Burn something of a higher order of fragrance. It can make a difference, it really can. And it isn't just that it smells pleasant, it is how the body interprets it. Because remember, your entire body is not just taking it in through your nostrils. The entirety of your body is taking it in from head to foot. It's as if your whole body is one giant nasal passage. And it's taking in the energy of this. Just think of your body as one big nose, okay? And that is the influence that this fragrance is having on you. And when you have positive fragrances, it makes a difference, because where we go on our day-to-day missions of daily activities each day, we can go into areas where, whether we're registering or not, the fragrances of bad energy are around us. Not just bad thoughts, but bad thoughts and bad emotions actually have a stench to them. They really do. And so we want to offset this. And at the same time, conversely, if you have some type of perfume or cologne or something that you can wear that you feel is of a higher order, wear it. Because what we're trying to do is this. We're trying to get rid of negatives in our consciousness from the subconscious mind. So conversely, we shouldn't allow any new ones in. In other words, if we're getting rid of some here this morning, why go out into daily life and have more come in? So we're just recirculating and recirculating. We never get anywhere. We become like the hamster on the treadmill. So there's nothing to be gained. Next thing says vocabulary. Have you noticed that people's vocabulary has changed in recent years? I'm embarrassed to go to the mall. I really am, because I may get behind somebody who's carrying on a conversation. And every other word is quite descriptive, and every other word seems to be the same word or same two words. It's almost that the American language has disintegrated into one word or two words. When I hear this going on, I don't think it's just part of a generation. I think it is just part of how society has degraded itself, and how we have allowed a few people that manipulate us to degrade the rest of us. There are a few people, whether it's in motion pictures, mass media, and so forth, that would love it just to have you just go further and further down the tubes, because that way they can control you. The more people can degrade you, the less self-esteem you have, the less you think about yourself, and the more then they can manipulate you and use you. Whether this is in the guise of politics, whether it's in the guise of social order, whether it's in the guise of religion, the same thing applies. Always make the person feel that they are sinners, that they are no good, and therefore some big brother in the form of a politician, in the form of a religious leader, is going to come along and save your soul. Well, if we can get people talking, the thing is, in all of these negative terms, they degrade themselves. I see nothing humorous, but it shows how what consciousness has pervaded us. When I'll turn on a cable television and I'll see some comic using these three words, one word singular, two words, every other thing out of their mouth. They don't have to do this. Some of these comics are funny on their own without having to resort to this vocabulary. Yet the worst part about it is there's an audience that has been sold by the manipulators that this is the way to respond. Oh, ha, 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 he just said the two words again. Ha, 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 she just said the one word again. Ha, 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 isn't that funny? I see nothing funny, and I see a bunch of baboons sitting in these audiences that have been manipulated so badly as to think this. Because the moment you start in to have that as your everyday lingo, you have degraded yourself. Don't tell me it's part of a generation. Don't tell me it's part of a culture. Don't tell me all of these politically correct things, because you are spiritually incorrect in becoming politically correct. Do you understand what I'm saying here? We have to upgrade. Can you imagine? Can you imagine Jesus using this vocabulary? Can you imagine Buddha using this vocabulary? Can you imagine Krishna using this vocabulary? Socrates using this vocabulary? Emerson using this vocabulary? Troward using this vocabulary? Plato using this vocabulary? Do you see it? This vocabulary written in the most beautiful pieces of music ever composed? In the most beautiful pieces of poetry ever written? No. Then don't let the manipulators in Hollywood manipulate you and downgrade you. Don't let the people that are in religion downgrade you. Yes, we have negatives. A person can be filled with negatives. A person can be on the outer surface what looks like total evil, but everything is of God, and if we penetrate that soul deeply enough, we will find light. The darkness seems to be all around. So, if you're ever tempted to make this a part of your vocabulary because you feel it's in, and like on cue, you're like this headless audience that responds to this junk vocabulary, then catch yourself and say, every time I use these profane expressions, I am filling myself with greater negativity, and that greater negativity is going to bounce back and go against my positiveness. I think all of you are aware of the expression that we all grew up with. He or she is full of... Isn't it wonderful I have an adult audience here? I can be very outspoken. Now, the next affirmation is something that you've never heard before, because it came from the God self inside of me. Remember, we're a psychophysical unit. Matter and energy are interchangeable with the other. Your thoughts are energy factors. And if you have negative thoughts, they're energy factors. And all negative thoughts can be converted into and are exchangeable with matter. All of you follow that? All of you in agreement with it? Hopefully. If you aren't, I'm not going to hear from you anyway, so. Okay, here's what we have. The affirmation says, are you ready for this on a Sunday morning? I affirm that in my daily physical body's processing, that negative thought and feeling energy stored in my subconscious memory is converted to waste matter and eliminated from my body as part of its natural functioning. Now, I know you haven't heard that before. Yeah, that's a Dr. Masters original from Christ within Dr. Masters. Thank you very much. Now, but I want you to think about this. I know you've never heard it before. I never heard it before it came through me. But then when it came through me, I started to think about this. And I started to think, hey, if our minds are filled with all of this negative energy and energy is converted to matter, why not just pass it from the body? I know, it has its own sense of humor. But can you see the reality of it?
Yeah.
Okay, we know as an example that if a person has a fever and the fever breaks, the person has excessive perspiration and the toxics, whatever is causing this, the energy factors flow out from this fever as it breaks. So what is so absurd about this particular idea and this principle? Nothing. So, give yourself this idea into your consciousness each day. It's like a spiritual ex-lax, or however you want to think about it. And give it to yourself each day, and realize that as you're going through your daily processes, that why not have some of this negative energy in your personal subconscious mind just flow out through the waste material. It converts to waste material, and it passes out. I know, it's different. But those of you, some of you here in the nursing field, some of you, I know, you've been around situations and people and so forth. You've been around people that are mentally ill, along with physically. You know that there's a very thin line here between matter, energy, and mind. So why not take advantage of the principle? Now, if you never forget everything else I've said here this morning, I think you're going to remember this one. The sun's energy. Now, we know that the sun has a life-giving effect on the body. We all know that, and we all recognize it. We recognize what this world would be like without the sun. And we also recognize that the sun can be converted into energy, and that energy can come out in orange juice, as an example, as vitamin C. It can come out in different ways. It can have an effect on our bodies. As an example, if I have a day where I start towards the end of the day not to feel well, one of the things I've made a practice of doing for many, many years, and that is before I retire, I'll take and fill a glass full of orange juice, put it on my nightstand, and before I fall asleep, I'll just sit up in bed and just sip the orange juice and just have the feeling that that energy is going through my body. Now, of course, I'll slip in a couple of capsules of 1,000 milligrams of vitamin C along with it, but the main thing is I know that the orange juice itself is instantly converted faster than those tablets are containing the C. It's instantly going into me. So what am I doing? I'm taking really a part of the sun into my system is what I'm doing. And the ancients believed that the sun was a living thing, and it is a living thing. It's a living being. It's a living heart. I said a few moments ago that the central part of our upper torso is where the seed of God exists. In the solar system, the seed of God exists in the sun. Everything from the infinite becomes scaled down, scaled down, scaled down. And in each scaling down, there is the representation or where the God center is. So in our solar system, the God center of our solar system is the sun. And hence now, we know we have that healing effect upon ourselves by taking in the sun's rays as far as our physical body. But why not also think of this, if you go out, let's say, for a spiritual health bath or a spiritual sun health bath, you're sitting out perhaps in your patio, on your balcony, wherever it might be, and you're sitting down and you're feeling the sun coming to you, and you feel this life-giving sun rays filling the whole of your body with its energy and its renewal. Why not also think to yourself and mentally visualize that the sun's rays here are also dissipating and sublimating any type of gray, darkened, negative types of energy or thought forms floating around in your personal subconscious. Because we are a psychophysical unit. So what is taking place as far as the sun's rays, the effects that they're having on your body, also having an effect on your mind, clearing your mind. And if you do this, you'll feel better, not just physically, but when you stand up after you've done this for a while, if you've had some negative thinking that day or recently, you'll feel much, much better in terms of how you're thinking and how you're feeling now. The sun is a health giver, not just physically, but mentally and emotionally. The sun's rays can reach down past our conscious mind into our subconscious and have an effect there. So why not focus in on this? Because the more that we focus in on anything going on within ourselves, the more we become part of that. So once again, it says, whenever the sun is shining, I take a few moments to close my eyes and imagine that positive sun ray consciousness energy is entering my body, mind, energy field, transforming negative energies into positive energies. And finally, the greatest thing that we can do to eliminate any type of darkness within ourselves is to bring light to that darkness. The way we bring light into that darkness is to bring forth the light that already exists within us. It isn't that any light has to be added to us. We come into this life fully self-illumined. The only thing about it is that we become so enmeshed in this, our outer sense activities, that we fail to remember that within ourselves there is light. You know, that to me there's no such thing as spiritual growth. There is only remembering. Think about that. There's no such thing as spiritual. We are what we are. We are the living embodiment of a Christ-like being, a being that is one with God. So it's not a matter of growing into anything that we're not already. It's a matter of remembering or reawakening, as it were, to what we already are. So the affirmation says Christing. And I like the word Christing because it says this is something that is in motion. This is something that is really happening. So it says, daily, I take a few moments to visualize or imagine the positive energy, body, mind, field of Christ, seen as a figure of Jesus, entering into all parts of my body, and that in such a positive God-light energy field, negative body, mind energies are sublimated into positive God-light. Now, why should we use a figure of Jesus? We know that the Christ was embodied in Jesus. We know that the Christ consciousness or Christ light is in every one of us. So why should we take a figure historically of Jesus and superimpose it? In other words, all of you are aware of the idea of being possessed by an evil entity. Why not be possessed by a higher spiritual? But we're not talking about an entity. We recognize that for the process of visualization, it perhaps for many people is more an easier way, let's say, to get to visualizing this. If you take whatever you imagine the historical figure of Jesus to be, knowing that that figure contains the Christ self, and it isn't the Jesus that's really important, it's the Christ part of Jesus that's important, and imagine that this figure is now coming close to you and then just becoming a total part of your body. Jesus' head becomes your head, Jesus' upper torso becomes your upper torso, Jesus' legs become your legs, Jesus' feet become your feet. And so you have this superimposition here of this state of beingness taken into your body. Again, it is not the historical figure of Jesus, it is what Jesus embodied, and which is with no different in any one of us because all of us contain the same thing. So all we're doing here is using an exercise in visual form to bring it home to us. Do all of you follow that? We're just using a visual form to make it a little bit easier, because sometimes our human minds live so much in a concrete world that thinking in abstracts, oftentimes we lose a little bit in the translation. So why not just utilize this and involve ourselves in then Christing ourselves? All right, those are some thoughts to be added to last week's presentation of part one of clearing your mind of negatives. And now I'm going to ask that you sit back in your chairs and Put both feet flat on the floor or ankles crossed, and let's take a few moments to go into a state of meditation, to feel a sense of oneness and wholeness with that presence that is at the center of our being, that Christ-like presence within ourselves where our personal self merges as one presence with the mind of God. And so now I turn inward to that higher state of beingness and reality within myself. I move from the outer levels of my mind to enter into the innermost pathways and corridors of consciousness within me. Consciousness and corridors that lead me to the eternal brilliance of God's light within me. And so I close off my outer senses to the exterior world, that I may open my inner senses to an inner world of mind, of soul, and of spirit. And as I do, I recline back into myself. The senses that I use for outer sense perception now become senses that I'm using for inner sense perception. My inner sense of sight opens within the interior regions of my forehead and throughout my body down to the reproductive area. My body is as a hollow on a spiritual level, where I'm able to look in and to see beyond physical reality into my own spiritual beingness, to in this state seek out the light that has created me, knowing that I am always part of that light and that my true nature is oneness with God, Christ-like beingness, oneness with God, that I cannot be separated from God nor God from me, that I choose to meet with God in the Christ being of light within myself, that every breath that I breathe into my body fans the spiritual flame of aspiration, leading and guiding me upward into an ascent within myself to that higher state of Christ consciousness, oneness with God within my own beingness. My whole body is an open receptacle to receive that beingness right here and right now. I exist in a state of internal rapture, one with spirit, mind, presence, that is God. One with the creative process that created the stars, the heavens, the planets, created all life forms. I am one with that which has been, is, and will forever be. And through that presence, I acknowledge the immortality of my own soul. And now for a few moments, I sit quietly, feeling and sensing that reality. In a few moments, I'll once again open my eyes and my senses to the exterior world, but I will retain a contact with the interior world of my own mind, soul, and spirit. And so now, ever so slowly, I'll begin to open my eyes. And as I open my eyes, I'll stretch my arms and my hands high over my head in a symbolic gesture of always reaching for something higher in my life, knowing that that something higher that I reach for is to be found in the height of who and what I truly am within myself, a living, breathing manifestation of the stars, of the heavens, of universal life, mind, and spirit, having taken image, shape, form, and embodiment. And I bring down my hands, now resting in the peace, the security, that this is so. And so it is.